Thank you very much, Engineer Ranjit Gunadelaka, for giving everybody food for thought and your words of inspiration in your keynote address. Well, we now move on to another very special moment, and it's indeed a pleasure for me to be reading the profile of our chief guest, because just like I feel I'm part of the IESL family now by comparing practically every year for IESL, I've had the wonderful opportunity of being a compere of practically every event this gentleman gave me when he was commander of the Sri Lanka Navy. Well, ladies and gentlemen, he was educated at Royal College Colombo. He has, of course, won the Navodaya Scholarship in Studies. He joined the Sri Lanka Navy in November 1980 as an officer cadet and was privileged to join the prestigious Britannia Royal Naval College, Dartmouth, United Kingdom, being the best executive cadet of the batch. He was a recipient of the Best International Midshipman Award at BRNC Dartmouth in the year 1982. He is specialized in anti-submarine warfare and is a qualified diver, paratrooper, and a special forces person. He earned his BSc honors degree in war studies from the Karachi University, Pakistan in 1996 and MPhil in defense and strategic studies, first class, from the University of Madras, India in 2010. He has been awarded with 4 distinguished medals for his acts of gallantry, valor, bravery in the face of enemy that included Virodhara Vibhushanaya, Ranavikrama Parakrama, and Ranasura Padakkama. He is also widely known as an expert in asymmetric naval warfare and small boat operations. Ladies and gentlemen, he is the founder of Sri Lanka Navy Special Boat Squadron, the Naval Commando Unit, and also he was the person who commanded this unit twice in his career. He was an outstanding sportsman and has won Navy colors for rugby football, sailing, and rowing. Ladies and gentlemen, he's a top marksman and a golfer who introduced the game of golf to the Sri Lanka Navy. He was appointed as the commander of the Navy on 11th July 2015 and appointed as the Chief of Defense Staff on the 22nd of August 2017. In 2019, the government of Pakistan awarded the Order of Excellence, Nishan-e-Imtiaz Military Medal, to this personality for his unmatched contribution towards strengthening of Sri Lanka-Pakistan defense relations. Without further ado, I have the pleasure of inviting our chief guest this morning, Admiral Ravindra Vijayagunaratne, better known to everybody as Ravi, to address you all.
Thank you for that kind introduction. Managing Director of Sankan Construction, Engineer Ranjit Gunatilaka, President of the IESL 2018-2019, Engineer Professor T.M. Pallevatta, my classmate in Royal College in 1980, President of the IESL 2019-2020, Engineer Professor S.B. Abekon, President-elect, Vice President-elect for the IESL 2019-2020, Engineer K.P.I.U. Dharmapala, and senior officials on the head table, IESL past presidents, IESL council members, members, secretaries and managing directors of governments and other organizations, our foreign friends from Bangladesh, India, Nepal, and Pakistan, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I wish to thank the president and all the members of the institution of Engineers Sri Lanka for inviting me to attend this 113th annual session of the IESL as the chief guest. I consider it as an honor and privilege to address this elite gathering of the engineers. Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka, being a premium body of the professional engineers in Sri Lanka, ensures internationally recognized standards in the professional practice and the education of engineering. With over 22,000 members, the IESL proudly stand today and celebrate its 130th anniversary as one of the leading professional institutions in engineering and technology in the world. The IESL has made great contribution to the development of the country through the innovative engineering and ladies and gentlemen, 113 years is a long time. I wonder how it would have been when this institution established in 1906 and at the Engineering Association of Ceylon in Anuradhapura and had their first meeting. I wonder how many members attended that meeting. As we all know, engineers play an extremely important role in the modern society. Over the past few decades, the technology progress has been nothing short of amazing. Most of the new devices and technologies that we have today are the result of hard work and dedication of engineers and their teams. Today, our lives have become easier, and I would even say less complicated, due to the great innovations by an outstanding community of engineers around the world. This is simply because engineers do not sit back and watch. They make their things happen. You are impacting the entire world, unlike others, through innovations, creativity, and your wealth of knowledge. Further in Sri Lanka, most of us are the children of free education. Thanks to Dr. C.W.W. Kannangara, our first Minister of Education in the State Council, even before our independence from the British Empire, Free Education Bill was passed and came into effect on 1st October 1945. This bill says education should be free from kindergarten to university. Dr. Kannangara established central schools, modeling Royal College Colombo 7 outside major cities, taking the quality secondary education to the rural outstations of the country. It says in 1941, there are only 3 central schools, which became 35 by 1945, and rise to 50 central schools by 1950. In 1943, Dr. Kannangara launched annual scholarship program, which provided the opportunity for 20 best performers to get free boarding and lodging in the central schools' hostels. I feel this action by this great leader allow our children to reach university education with equal opportunities. But what is important here to note about Dr. Kannangara is the young Kannangara went to Richmond College Goal from Wesleyan Missionary Primary School in Randome, Balapitiya on a foundation scholarship which gave him the free boarding and lodging in Richmond. He was the captain of the Richmond cricket team in 1903. He was a member of the soccer team. He obtained highest marks in Ceylon and in British Empire list in the Cambridge Senior Examination in Mathematics in 1903. But he was not able to go to the university as his parents could not afford to send him. Instead of going to university, he became a mathematics teacher. This great man gave us what he could not achieve due to lack of money by establishing free education to Sri Lanka. So this country has given us a lot to reach our positions today. We should not forget that. The engineering portfolio knows no boundaries. The most important thing that I observe is that all these brilliant minds are working toward the building the sustainable world. Whatever you wish to contribute to the society through your knowledge, nothing can be compared to what you have done to change the lives of the people. I personally believe that an engineer who driven not only by the technical know-how, but also by the considerations of social impact and political feasibility, will be more effective in helping to develop long-lasting solutions. Ladies and gentlemen, I consider it is my duty to highlight some of the outstanding contribution made by the engineers in our armed forces in bringing lasting peace to our country. Especially the Sri Lankans who are here today have seen the hard work of our gallant men and women in uniform, fought nearly 3 decades to eradicate terrorism from our soil. But I doubt whether you are fully aware of some of the outstanding contributions made by the engineers in uniform. Their innovation not only deter the enemy, but also save billions of rupees to the country, which would have been paid otherwise to the foreign defense production companies. To mention a few, the Center for Research and Development, or CRD, was established in 2006 to jointly find out the solution for the technical issues encountered by the Triforces in the battlefield. Apart from that, there are individual research and development units in the respective forces that came out with engineering innovations relevant to their respective service. The Army produced jammers to prevent the activation of the LTT improvised explosive devices during the wartime, and which saves lives of many soldiers. On the other hand, they produced remotely controlled lightweight exploders, which were successfully used by our special forces men on long-range recce patrol missions, who penetrated the enemy lines and targeted the vehicles carrying the terrorist leaders. Also, the Army produced protective armored personnel carriers, which are being successfully used even today by the troops in United Nations deployment, including in Mali. The Army and Air Force jointly developed the technology to provide the live picture feed from the unmanned aerial vehicles to the operation rooms of service commanders, enable them to take important strategic and operational decisions. Even after the war, Army progressed with their R&D capabilities and produced firing simulators for both artillery and small arms, facilitating the training of the gunners in absence of the artillery firing range in Sri Lanka. Ladies and gentlemen, the Navy also made major innovation during the conflict time. When employed, these innovations became force multipliers. They did the weapon system upgrading by reverse engineering and incorporated multi-barrel rocket launcher systems, which were specially designed for ground to used out at sea with the stabilized naval platforms and effectively used out at sea. Our engineers made transfer of real-time battle picture to commander's desk, enabling him to take critical decisions. There is saying in our Navy, you can't buy a Navy, you have to build one. The Navy started the indigenous building of small boats, small combat boats, to match the enemy's small boats and the suicide boats. And we manufactured to outnumber them in the battlefield, producing over 100 each small combat boats and inshore patrol craft with the inboard water jet engines at our own yards. Navy also established own ship design directorate and even exported few of our patrol craft to Nigeria and Seychelles. The engineers of Navy supported the destruction of the LTT floating warehouses, which operated more than 1,200 nautical miles away from our shore, by ensuring the reliability of the engines and the control system of our old ships. They are the unsung heroes of our war. I am proud to mention here that we have a self-sufficient Navy, thanks to our engineers, as we do all major repairs and maintenance work of our craft by ourselves, where the all big navies such as US, Australia, and India outsourcing their ship maintenance and repairs. Even the post-war scenario, naval engineers continue to contribute in the nation-building efforts and other projects such as the President's Task Force on Prevention of Chronic Kidney Disease by producing more than 700 reverse osmosis plants for benefit of the people in Anuradhapura, Polonnaruwa and Kurunagala districts. Ladies and gentlemen, this each plant give 10,000 liters of clean drinking water, like your bottled water, free of cost every day. That is more than 7 million liters of drinking water every day we produce. And a huge project single-handedly manned by the Navy. As Mother Teresa said, not all of us can do great things, but we can do small things with great love. Ladies and gentlemen, the engineers of our Air Force also make an unmatched contribution to our war effort in many ways. Production of Linear Mark II UAV, one of their innovations, which perfectly worked in the air surveillance. As further proof of their professional engineering contribution, it is pertinent to note that the Air Force aircraft maintenance engineers have made a number of major contributions in sphere of aircraft engineering. One of the major achievements these highly professional engineers thus was conversion of De Havilland Heron Mark II D aircraft into a really Heron aircraft by enhancing its performance and range. Another such contribution was the construction of Pasmini PL-2 aircraft totally by the Air Force personnel. Furthermore, Air Force aircraft engineers have also designed and built on their own an airworthy ultra-light aircraft, as well as completely rebuilt and put that to service with the manufacturer's approval, 4 Bell 212 helicopters, which has crashed during the height of internal conflict, thereby saving millions of rupees to our nation. Ladies and gentlemen, I could easily continue the list, but my intention was to highlight these unique contributions to make you aware the unsung heroes who contributed immensely to make our victory easier than many expected. Even though they have been commended by the respective service commanders, these engineers deserve wider recognition in forums such as this. Ladies and gentlemen, I strongly believe that the IESL play an important role in setting up the standards in professional practice and education in the engineering of our development field of engineering for better tomorrow. Finally, I just want to give something to you. The youngest elected president of US, President John F. Kennedy, who became the president at the age of 43, gave his inaugural speech after taking oath as the president from the Eastern Portico of the Capitol Hill on 20th January 1961. His speech was only 14 minutes, same time that I have taken today. This speech is considered as one of the shortest and best inaugural speeches. He said at the end of his speech, "Ask not what your country can do for you. Ask what you can do for your country." I ask the same from you. Ask not what your country can do for you. Ask what you can do for your country. I wish that the Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka continue to prosper and contribute to the development of our country through engineering excellence. I wish IESL good luck. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Chief Guest Admiral. Thank you for your thought-provoking address, sharing your wealth of experience with us, and your sincere wishes. Thank you once again. Ladies and gentlemen, we now move on to the presentation of awards and certificates. Starting off, of course, with the junior inventors, I would like to invite our chief guest. Sir, can we please have you to step forward, Admiral Ravindra Vijayagunaratne, accompanied by Engineer Professor T.M. Pallavatta, President IESL, and Engineer Professor S.B.S. Abeyakon, President-elect. Should we put our hands together and give them a round of applause, everybody? We begin with the Junior Inventor of the Year Competition 2019 winners, recognizing the winners. In third place, we have joint winners in Miss Viduni Punara and Miss U.S. Amalja Mansati from Sacred Heart Convent, Goal. They'll receive a bronze medal, a certificate, and 15,000 rupees, and 15,000 rupees in cash. This is their product that they invented, a microscope, which can be worn on the head as well. Everybody, put your hands together and give them a round of applause. The joint winners from Sacred Heart Convent, Goal, Viduni Punara and Amalja Mansati. And securing second place in the Junior Inventor of the Year 2019 is Master J.L.P. Jeevaka Ranasinghe from Jnanodaya Mahavidyalaya, Kalutara South, Kalutara. He receives a silver medal, a certificate, and 17,500 rupees in cash. This is the product he invented, instantly removing rainwater and fog in the side mirror of the vehicle. I'm sure we can put our hands together for him as well. Jeevaka Ranasinghe from Jnanodaya Mahavidyalaya, Kalutara South, Kalutara. These are the inventors all out of Colombo. Wonderful to see that. And the winner, the title award winner of the Junior Inventor of the Year 2019 is from Girls High School Kandy, Miss Uttara Madagoda. And her product, her invention is a multi-rice cooker. She wins a gold medal, a certificate, and 20,000 rupees in cash. Everybody, put your hands together for the winner, Uttara Madagoda from Girls High School Kandy. Congratulations. Right, we now move on to the presentation of certificates to the corporate members who've been registered as international professional engineers. They are Engineer M.G. D. D. Silva. Engineer Mrs. G.A.S.C. Samararatna. Engineer B.S. Gunasekara. Engineer P. Dammika Dharmaratna. Engineer P. R. Saratchandra Kumara. And Engineer M. N. C. Samaravikrama. We now move on to the awarding of honorary life membership to senior members. Engineer M.K. Hapuarachi. Engineer Dr. G.A.K. Padmaperuma. Engineer D.R. Pullaperuma. And Engineer J.W. M.R.T. Seaman. We now move on to recognizing corporate members who have been elected as fellows and awarded certificates. Engineer M.N. Ranuraja. Engineer Major W.M.N. Vasala Bandara. Engineer Ms. R.M.D. Javardhana. Engineer W.K. S. Chandraratna. Engineer S.A. Rashid. Engineer Ms. K.A. Adihetti. Engineer Dr. S. Vikramaratna. Engineer P.D. Dharmaratna. Engineer Commander J.A.D.G.E.K. Jatilaka. Engineer Ms. Nalayani P. Gunavardhana. Engineer D.A.J. Nanyakkara. Engineer D.W.R. Vijayveera. Engineer Mrs. G.A.S.C. Samararatna. Engineer K.P.R.S. Samarasingha. Engineer M.G.D.D. Silva. Engineer K.S.M. Silva. And Engineer K.D.P.F. Sirivardhana. We also recognize the honorary life members who are Engineer K.A.A.P. Kurupuarachi and also life members Engineer P. Kalubovila. And Engineer K. Jagachandra. Everybody, let's put our hands together and give all of them a round of applause. And thank you very much, our presentation party. Thank you. I now would like to invite for the presentation of special awards, Engineer Ranjit Gunathilaka, our keynote speaker, accompanied by Engineer Professor T.M. Pallavatta, President IESL. Everybody put your hands together and give them a round of applause. These are the special awards. The Professor E.O.E. Pereira Award for the best paper presented at the annual sessions 2018 by a member titled Evaluation of the Variability Characteristics of Distributed Solar PV Production from Grid Integration Perspective to Engineer AWMRB Vijaykon, Engineer Ms. D.C. Hapuarachi, and Engineer M.B.S. Samarasekara. I'm sure we can put our hands together and give them another round of applause. The IESL Award for the best paper by a corporate member published in the Engineer Journal during the sessions 2018-2019 by Engineer H.A.H. Amanda, Engineer Professor W.D.A.S. Vijayapala, Engineer Professor J.R. Lucas, and Engineer W.J.L.S. Fernando for their paper titled The Economic Comparison of Reservoir Type and Run-of-the-River Type Hydropower Plants, a Case Study for Upper Kotmale Hydro Plant. Being corporate members, the IESL Award is presented to Engineer Professor W.D.A.S. Vijayapala, Engineer Professor J. are Lucas and Engineer W.J.L.S. Fernando. And the SDNCC Award for the best paper by an associate member published in the Engineer Journal during the session 2018-2019 by Engineer HMAD Jayasundara, Engineer SMNH Kulia Bandara, and Engineer Dr. KK Vijayasundara for their paper titled Wind Loads on Tall Buildings, Comparative Study of International Wind Codes and Numerical Simulation. Being associate members, the SDNCC Award 2019 is presented to Engineer Dr. KK Vijayasundara. Let's put our hands together and give all the recipients another round of applause. And thank you very much, our presentation party. Ladies and gentlemen, we now move on to the presentation of a medallion by the incumbent president, Engineer Professor T.M. Pallavatta, to the immediate past president, Engineer Professor Mrs. Niranjani Ratnayaka, in appreciation of her services to the institution during the session 2017-2018. Please stay where you are because I need to give an introduction to her as well. She was the president of the Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka for the session 2017-2018. In the history of 113 years, this is the second time that a female engineer became president, the highest position that an engineer can achieve in his or her professional career. Before getting to this prestigious position, she was actively involved in her professional career. She served as the founder chairperson of the Women Engineers Forum and chairperson of the Civil Engineering Sectional Committee of IESL. She was elected to the IESL Council and served as a representative of fellows, vice president and president-elect in the past. And of course, she is an emeritus professor of the University of Moratuwa, the title awarded on her retirement from service as a senior professor in civil engineering. Her field of specialization is environmental engineering. In September 2002, she was promoted to the post of professor on merit at the University of Moratuwa, thus becoming the first ever female professor in any field of engineering in the Sri Lankan university system. She has won several prestigious awards, including a Presidential Award for Research in 2020, Zonta Woman of Achievement Award in Engineering and IT in 2002, and the late Professor E.O.E. Pereira Award for the best paper presented at the IESL annual sessions in October 2014. IESL recognized her by awarding the Outstanding Engineering Education Award of Excellence in 2015. Ladies and gentlemen, she is currently working as the chairperson of the National Science and Technology Commission, the statutory board mandated to advise the government on policies and plans for the development of science and technology relevant to the sustainable development of Sri Lanka. She, ladies and gentlemen, is a person who's been gathering professionals of all disciplines committed to the common goal of a clean planet and sustainable development. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a very special moment, the presentation of a medallion by the incumbent president, Engineer Professor T.M. Pallavatta, to the immediate past president, Engineer Professor Mrs. N. Ratnayaka, in appreciation of her services to the institution during the session 2017-2018. Well, what is coming up right now is definitely the moment of the day. It's the induction of the president for the session 2019-2020. Ladies and gentlemen, he graduated in 1979 with a BSc engineering degree in civil engineering with a first class honors from the University of Peravania. He obtained a MSc degree and a PhD degree from the University of British Columbia, Canada in 1983 and 1987 respectively. He became a member of the Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka in 1993 and gradually became a fellow and an international professional engineer. He served in the Council of IESL for many years and held the position of vice president as well. He held the post of Dean of the Faculty of Engineering from 2005 to 2009, followed by the position of vice chancellor of the University of Peravania 2009 to 2012. His professional engagements overseas include those with South Asian University, India, the Asian Disaster Preparedness Center, Bangkok, Thailand, International Institute for Infrastructure Renewable and Reconstruction based in Calgary, Canada, and the University Network for Climate and Ecosystems Change Research based in Tokyo, Japan. Ladies and gentlemen, he was a visiting professor at the United Nations University Tokyo, Japan from 2012 to 2013, a visiting professor at the University of British Columbia, Canada from 1998 to 2001, and a research fellow at the University of Tokyo, Japan in 1997. He currently serves as a senior professor in civil engineering at the University of Peradeniya. Ladies and gentlemen, this personality was the natural choice of His Excellency the President to head as the chairman of the Inaugural Engineering Council of Sri Lanka, a body specially enacted by an Act of Parliament in 2017 to regulate engineering practice in Sri Lanka. Ladies and gentlemen, Engineer Professor S.B.S. Abeyakon is elected President of IESL for 2019-2020 session. And now we move on to that very special moment, the induction of the President for the session 2019-2020, Engineer Professor S.B.S. Abeyakon, by the outgoing President, Engineer Professor T.M. Pallavatta. This is that very special moment. I'm sure we can have a standing ovation. This is a very special moment. This is where the induction takes place. Everybody, a round of applause. Thank you very much. You may be seated. I have great pleasure now in inviting Engineer Professor S.B.S. Abeyakon, the newly elected president for the session 2019-2020, to address this August gathering. Congratulations, sir.
Thank you very much, Mr. Faisal Bonso, for that introduction where you have elaborated my achievements in academic as well as professional spheres magnificently. Everything I have achieved should be credited to the strong base inculcated in me by my dear parents. The input that comes from parents is supreme, and my parents are the ones who made me realize what I am and I am capable of. And they are the ones who made me believe that I have the necessary skills and capability to accomplish my goals. Although they would have been the happiest today, unfortunately for me, they could not be here today to see me placed in this esteemed position. Engineer Professor T.M. Pallavatta, President of Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka, our chief guest today. Guest of honor and keynote speaker, Engineer Ranjit Gunatilaka, Managing Director of Sunken Construction Private Limited. Chairman of Board of Trustees, Engineer Professor A.K. Jayawardena. Officials of Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka, comprising three Vice Presidents, Honorary Secretary, and Honorary Treasurer. Chief Executive Officer and Executive Secretary of IESL, President-elect Engineer K.P. I.U. Dharmapal, immediate past President, Engineer Professor Mrs. Niranjani Ratnayake, past Presidents, members of the Council, distinguished invitees, including delegates from the regional engineering institutions, Bangladesh, India, Nepal, and Pakistan, fellow engineers, all members of the IESL Secretariat, students from universities and schools, award winners, their teachers and parents, well-wishers, and members of the media. I have held a few positions in my life, but never headed an institution that boasts a 113-year history. More importantly, as engineering plays the key role in development of a nation, Getting elected as the president of IESL places you at a position where direct contributions can be made to this wonderful country of ours. I take this opportunity to thank all my fellow engineers for trusting me to lead you in the incoming session of Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka. Ladies and gentlemen, my home village, Udupi-Radhaniya, where I still live, borders the University of Peradeniya on southern and western directions. My primary education, at least the formal part of it, was at the Udupi-Radhaniya school, but the extracurricular part was nourished at the university premises from kindergarten ages. We used university grounds to play and university lands to hide and seek, and my parents took me to all cultural events at the university, including the annual drama festival of the Professor at the Professor Edhivira Sarachandra Memorial Open Air Theatre. I recollect my mother saying that I have watched the first staging of Singhabahu on her lap at the age of 3. I entered St. Sylvester's College, Kandy, from grade 6 and returned to the University of Peradeniya, this time as a registered undergraduate student in 1975, and I never left. In between, I was fortunate enough to enter the University of British Columbia, the best Canadian university for engineering at that time, for my higher studies. As a small boy, while walking me through the campus to the city of Peradeniya for my monthly haircut, I recall my father telling me about some distinguished scholars and teachers of the University of Peradeniya who happened to pass by us on foot or in their vehicles. These include Doric D'Souza, Tambaya Pille, Edhivira Sarachandra, Osman Jayaratna, Nicholas Artigala, J.E. Jayasurya, Karl Gunawardena, D.E. Hettiarachchi, Thiru Kandaya, E.O.E. Pereira, Senaka Bibile, K.N. Jayatilaka, Ashley Halpe, and Ralph Panabokke, to name a few. I believe just the sight of these great personalities as a young boy probably had an effect on me to pursue and continue my career at the same great place of learning. I take this opportunity to appreciate Talatuya Mahatmi, my teacher at Pahala Balanshya at Udupi-Radhaniya School, who even carried me within the school, and all my teachers at the two schools and the two universities I attended for properly educating me. I just use the term properly here in a holistic sense. I thank my colleagues at the university who paved the way for me to gain all important administrative experiences by electing and selecting me to many administrative positions in the university. I also thank the undergraduate students for training me to handle some extremely difficult and even volatile situations. I must say that once I started taking up different positions and responsibilities, it was my family that had to suffer. My wife and 4 children had to undergo numerous difficulties to keep me going in my path. My wife Jeevapani had to give up many opportunities in her own professional career to make room to take up all responsibilities of the family. My 4 children, Achini, Ruchini, Sasmita, and Chamindya, had to grow up without knowing when or on which day their father will come home again. When things were not going right, I sought the solace and advice of my parents-in-law, who were always there for help. For the last 31 years, they fulfilled all parental duties for me. I'm very happy that today they are here with my wife and three of my children. Ladies and gentlemen, although engineers are the driving force of development of a country, the extent to which engineering can aid is dependent upon governments committing financial and other resources required for development projects. More importantly, we also need a favorable working environment without corruption, an environment where rules and regulations are properly laid down, and more significantly, properly implemented. My dear fellow engineers, while we expect that from our rulers, until that comes through, there are things that we can do to improve ourselves in conducting our own affairs. I'm sure you will all agree with me that the main problem that prevails and is getting worse day by day among our engineers is that of attitude. We have also witnessed ethical issues, or rather lack of ethics, that tarnish our image as well as that of the country. Many a time, we have noted our members ignoring ethical practices, mostly under political pressures. Ethics is a vast area that also covers issues of attitudes. Therefore, in the session 2019-2020, we will launch programs specially designed to address the pressing concern of engineering ethics. I believe that if we do not do that now, it will be way too late to correct ourselves. And if we somehow manage to correct ourselves and instill ethical practices among all engineers, then we will be a force to reckon with in this country. Then and only then we can demand our governors to listen to us. And we then and only then that we can show the political hierarchy that engineers cannot be bought. So we will try our best to get there. Secondly, with the establishment of the Engineering Council in Sri Lanka, it is vital that we review the mission, vision, and the direction of IESL so that we can reposition ourselves for the benefit of our members and that of the country. In this context, it is extremely important that we work together with other engineering and professional organizations, realizing that the contribution of each organization is complementary to the development of the nation. I recall our keynote speaker also made this point very clear in his speech, Engineer Ranjit Gunatilak. By working together, we can move beyond some of our old wounds. In fact, we have no choice. We absolutely have no choice. We have to work together. Thirdly, as the main stakeholder of Association of Practicing Engineers, Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka should get itself actively engaged in reforming engineering education in Sri Lanka. This is an area that needs vital and continued inputs from Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka, as we need to align engineering education with the current trends of the world. This was stressed by our President, Professor T.M. Pallavath, and also again by our guest speaker, Engineer Ranjit Gunatilak. We need to work with providers of higher education as well as with the University Grants Commission to achieve our goals. Finally, it is necessary to continue and complete the restructuring process of Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka Secretariat that was initiated last month. This will also include the thorough review of our infrastructure facilities. Ladies and gentlemen, I was very fortunate to receive unconditional support of all the members, the councils, past presidents, and the secretariat in successfully completing all tasks that were entrusted to me by the Institution of Sri Lanka over many, many years. I have no doubt that this help, this commitment will continue in the incoming session as well, so that we all can together work towards achieving the aforementioned objectives. That will make sure that we all take a step in the right direction to uplift the standards of people of this great country of ours. They are the ones who have paid for the so-called free education to almost all of us without expecting anything in return. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Everybody, put your hands together for the newly elected president of the session 2019-2020, Engineer Professor S.B.S. Abeokon. Well, we now move on to recognizing our chief guest and our keynote speaker, and I would like to invite Engineer Professor T.M. Pallavatha, President IESL, session 2018-2019, to please step forward and present mementos to our chief guest first. Everybody, put your hands together for Admiral Ravindra Vijayagunaratne, Chief of Defence Staff, who is our chief guest today. Lovely having you with us. Thank you for your thought-provoking address, sharing your words of wisdom and wealth of experience. Everybody, put your hands together for our chief guest, Admiral Ravindra Vijayagunaratne. And not forgetting our keynote speaker for giving us words of inspiration. Everybody, put your hands together for Engineer Ranjit Gunathelaka, Managing Director, Sunken Construction Private Limited. Thank you very much. We've almost come to the end of this very special occasion. To propose the vote of thanks, I would like to invite a personality who graduated with a BSc Engineering degree from the University of Peradeniya in 1979. He holds a diploma in commercial arbitration obtained from the Institute for the Development of Commercial Law and Practice in 2012. He commenced his career in 1978 as a civil engineer at the River Valleys Development Board and served as a construction engineer, designs engineer, and senior project manager until 1985. In the River Valleys Development, he worked as a construction engineer in Ulhitia Oya Dam Project in System C and road construction work in Maduru Oya and Valikanda in System B under the Accelerated Mahavali Development Program. He joined, ladies and gentlemen, the Resources Development Consultants Limited as a consultant engineer in 1985 and then joined SDNCC. He was then attached to the CML MTD Construction Limited as Deputy General Manager in 1994 and was appointed as the General Manager Construction and Technical in 2004. And since 2013, he has served as the General Manager Project Planning and Designs of CML MTD, and now is serving as the CEO Director of the Unica Design Engineers and Consultants Private Limited. He was elected as a member of the Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka in 1983 and a fellow in 2001. He was elected as a member of the Institution of Civil Engineers United Kingdom in 1997 and fellow in 2001. He was admitted as a member of the Institution of Engineers Australia in 1991, became a fellow in 2005, and a registered professional engineer in 1994. He became a member of the American Society of Civil Engineers in 1991, and a member of the Society of Structural Engineers Sri Lanka in 1992. He's also a member of the Association of Consulting Engineers Sri Lanka. He was registered with the institution as an International Professional Engineer in 2008 and a registered adjudicator with the institution. He also has been a member of the Professional Review Examination Panels of the Institution of Civil Engineers United Kingdom and serves as a committee member of the Executive Committee of the Sri Lanka Association of Institution of Civil Engineers, United Kingdom, since 2008. Ladies and gentlemen, to propose a vote of thanks, I have the pleasure of inviting Engineer KPIU Dharmapala, President-elect 2019-2020.
President of the Institution of Engineers, Sri Lanka, our chief guest today, Chief of Defence Staff, Admiral R.C. Vijay Gunawardana, keynote speaker, Managing Director, CEO, Sunken Construction Private Limited, Engineer Major Ranjit Gunatilaka, distinguished members of the head table, our distinguished foreign guests and invitees, past presidents, council members, other invitees, members of the Institute of Engineers Sri Lanka, award winners, ladies and gentlemen. We have come to the end of the inauguration ceremony of 113 annual sessions of the Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka, which is the most important event in the IESL event calendar. Before we wind up, as the last item of this program, it is my privilege to deliver the vote of thanks at this grand occasion. The inauguration of the 130th annual session adds a new chapter to the grand history of IESL. It ushered in a new president who will be assisted by the council elected for the session 2019-20 to face the challenges that are both current and anticipated, and to maneuver the institution towards its vision through unprecedented times in the rate of change of the technology, while giving our blessings to the new president and the council's success and the success of the membership and the engineering profession in Sri Lanka. I will start my vote of thanks with our distinguished guest at the head table. Our chief guest today, Chief of Defence Staff, Admiral R.C. Vijay Gunawardana, we are very much indebted to you, sir, for accepting our invitation to be the chief guest at this flagship event of the institution. Keynote speaker, Engineer Major Ranjit Gunatilaka, you are not a new face to us, not a stranger to us, you are one of our members. While appreciating your wholehearted support, we thank you for accepting our invitation and gracing this occasion as our keynote speaker, despite your very busy schedules. Engineer Professor S.B. Abekon, President for the session 2019-20. Engineer Professor T.M. Pallevatta, President for the session 2018-19. Engineer Professor Niranjani Ratnayaka, immediate past president of the IESL. All past presidents, vice presidents, honorary secretary, honorary treasurer, and council members. Without your support, guidance, and continuous monitoring, this event could not have achieved its present status. I extend a very hearty word of thanks to all of you who contributed for the success of today's event. There are many distinguished foreign guests and invitees who have devoted their precious time to grace this occasion on our invitation. I am very much thankful to you, thankful to all of them for spending their time with us at this grand occasion. My whole heart gratitude goes to the staff of the IESL Secretariat, headed by the Chief Executive Officer, Executive Secretary Engineer Neil Abhesekara, and also his deputy engineer Anuradha Panditaratna for their hard work to ensure the success of institution's activities that culminated in this event. I also thank the members of the media who are here to cover this grand occasion. I would like to thank our compere, Mr. Faisal Bonso, who conducted this event in a very enthusiastic and elegant manner. I would like to thank the management of the BMICH for their fullest cooperation in organizing this inauguration ceremony successfully, while humbly requesting you to bear with me if I have inadvertently missed anyone of you worthy of being included in this vote of thanks. I wish to thank you all for being here with us today and gracing this occasion. We are honored as IESL by your presence here today. I wish you all a very pleasant day. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, and they say all good things should come to an end, so it is with the inauguration of the 113th annual sessions of the Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka. It's been an honor, privilege, and a pleasure to have been the compere. I wish all of you all success and a very pleasant day. You've been a wonderful audience. Thank you very much. We'd like all of you to stay in your seats till the main procession leaves.